Okay, so these are the five questions based on last lecture. Write the first law of motion. So the first law of motion, this is actually the law of inertia. So if there is no force exerted on any body, then the state of that body will be remain same. If that body is in motion, obviously that will be in motion. And if that body is at rest, that will be at rest. This is known as law of motion or law of inertia, the first law of motion. Second is, what is the momentum, and write the physical impedance. So the momentum is the multiplication of mass and velocity. So it is represented by P. This is equal to mass multiplied by velocity. And you also have to write its units and dimension. So in terms of units, this is in kilogram and this is meter per second. And this momentum, this actually depends on mass as well as in velocity. So if we take this mass as constant, then this P, it is directly proportional to V. And the impact on any object, it depends on this mass and velocity. So this is the physical importance of this. Now discuss the second law of motion. So this second law of motion actually defines the force. And that force, this is directly proportional to rate of change of momentum. So, and the change, the direction is same, so this force is directly proportional to rate of change of momentum dp by dt. We take one constant k here, which is actually equivalent to 1 in SI system. So f is written is equivalent to dp by dt. So this p is the momentum, and we have several forms of the derivation. What is the force? Force is mass multiplied by acceleration, and it is derived from this. When we put this p as equal to this, f is equal to t m v by dt. So just a two steps of derivation. If mass is constant, so m is equal to dv by dt, and this is mass multiplied by acceleration. So this is force, which is the function of mass and acceleration. Now the last one, body of mass m, it is moving along x axis, and that x is given by this, x is equal to at. A is constant, b is constant, and c is also constant. So x is equal to at to the power 4 minus bt cube plus ct. You have to calculate the force at time t. So for force, the formula is f is equal to mass multiplied by acceleration. M is given, we have to calculate acceleration. X is given, so we can calculate acceleration. So the acceleration is that x, it is equal to, for that, it is a to the power 4 minus b t cube plus c t, like this. So in order to calculate force, we must have mass and acceleration. Mass is given here, so we have to calculate acceleration. So this, first we can calculate velocity dx by dt, which is equal to 4 a t cube minus 3 dt square plus c, just a single derivative, and then acceleration, that is 4 multiplied by 3 at square minus 3 multiplied by 2 bt plus 0, so it's constant, so derivation of this is 0. So this is equal to 12 at square minus 6 bt, this is that acceleration. So at any instant of time, we can calculate force. F is equal to mass multiplied by this 12 at square minus 6 bt. This is the force. So if that position is given, this is that displacement, as a function of time, we can calculate acceleration, and that will be the force. So these are the five questions of the day, and now we will start. So now we will start the third law of motion, but before that we have to introduce another physical quantity that is known as impulsive force. So this is another physical quantity, impulsive. Impulsive force is force, a large force implied an applied for any short instant of time. So impulsive force is one large force exerted on any body for a very short span of time. A very good example is that the batting. बॉलर जो है बॉल फेंकता है और बैट्समैन जो है वो बैट से उसको हिट करता है, तो जितने टाइम पे वो जो बॉल है उस बॉल पे फोर्स लगता है, दैट इज अ वेरी शॉर्ट स्पैन. लेकिन फोर्स की जो वैल्यू है, फोर्स का जो वैल्यू है बहुत हाई होता है. सो जो बहुत हाई वैल्यू का फोर्स बहुत शॉर्ट स्पैन बहुत शॉर्ट टाइम के लिए अगर कोई लगाया जाए तो उसको कहा जाता है दैट इज द इम्पल्सिव फोर्स. एंड दिस इज एक्चुअली इक्वल टू, दिस इज इन फैक्ट इक्वल टू the difference in momentum. So momentum का जो difference होता है उस momentum के difference के बराबर इसको derive किया जाता है, calculate किया जाता है. So impulsive force is a large force applied in any body, any system for a very small span of time. So the impulse is defined as, so impulsive force and impulse, this is the term. Impulse, it is denoted by, let's say short span of time. So this is del z. हमारे book में क्या notation दिया पता है, del I del z, I से भी ले जा सकता है. So this is, so we are not talking about current. So let us use this del di. It is equivalent to the force. This is the force and the instant, short instant means small time. So this is dt. So this impulse di, it is equivalent to f dt. In terms of integration, one can write that total impulse I can be written as equal to integration of f dt. So this is the formula. So this I is equal to force multiplied by that instant. If we have a plot between f and t, obviously this is integration. So we will talk about the area. So this, if this is that. Here this time is t1, here the time is t2, and force is constant. Then let us have this A, B, C and D. And this time difference is t2 minus t1 and the force is F. So the area will be, area of this, this will be F, that area, it is equal to F multiplied by t2 minus t1. This t2 minus t1 is that time difference. Very small. And if this is in form of that irregular curve like this, then we use integration. So if that simple discrete term is given, if a constant force is applied for the in between this instant t1 and t2, then we can calculate area directly by using simple geometrical formula. And if this this type of curve is given, then we have to calculate, we have to take the integration, and this will be form, and this is, let's say this is t1 and this is t2. So this will be from t1 to t2. So this, the limit is t1 to t2 and integration is f multiplied by t2. Now we have to prove this impulse is equal to the change in the momentum. So that one can write this is equivalent to integration of f multiplied by dt. And since from the second law of motion, what we have, from the second law of motion. But we have this force is equal to rate of change of momentum. So we can put here, and this impulse I, that's equal to integration of this dp by dt multiplied by dt. It can be cancelled out. So this is integration of dp. Now, in spite of t1 to t2, variable has been changed, dp. So we will write this is p1 by p2. From p1 to p2. So initial momentum is p1. And the final momentum, that is p2. So one can write this is equal to p2 minus p1. So the impulse is actually equal to the change in momentum. So what is that? The impulse is the large force applied for very short span of time. So this is very short span of time. We have calculated impulse, and one can prove this I is equal to P2 minus P1. Okay? So this is about the impulsive force, and we have several examples of this impulsive force in our daily life. Impulsive force, agar koi zyada lagta hai, usko agar hume kam karna ho, तो हमारे पास दो फैक्टर है, या तो फोर्स की वैल्यू कम होनी चाहिए या तो टाइम ज़्यादा होनी चाहिए, गेप अगर आपको ज़्यादा गेप ज़्यादा रखना पड़ेगा, है ना। जैसे बहुत सारा एग्जांपल्स इसमें दिया जाता है, कैच वाला जो ये रहता है, बॉल का कैच वाला, है ना, कैच लेते समय बहुत सारे जो प्लेयर्स होते हैं, मैक्सिमम प्लेयर्स को भी बताया जाता है, कोई बॉल अगर बहुत फास्ट बॉल है, उसको बॉल को यहाँ कैच करने के बजाय बॉल को इस तरह से यहाँ कैच किया जाता है, बॉल को कैच लेते समय हाथ को ऐसा पीछे खींचा जाता है, एंड द रीजन इज यहाँ अगर कोई कैच करेगा तो इम्पैक्ट जो है वो बॉल पे फास्ट पड़ेगा, हाथ को चोट लगेगी, तो उससे बचाने तो क्या है कि जो टाइम है इसे टाइम गेप को बढ़ा दिया जाता है, तो यहाँ से यहाँ तक जो टाइम गेप जो है वो बढ़ जाता है, तो टाइम गेप बढ़ने की वजह से इम्पल्स कम होता है, है ना, और उससे जो है वो चोट लगने की संभावना कम होती है। दूसरा, अगर बाय द वे हम कहीं से अगर कोई जंप कर रहे हैं, ये यहाँ पे अगर कोई सीमेंटेड रोप पे अगर कोई जंप करते हैं तो चोट लगती है, लेकिन वहीं पर अगर बाय द वे कहीं पर कोई सैंड है, रेतीला अगर कोई जगह है, वहाँ पे हम जब जंप करते हैं तो उसमें तो चोट नहीं लगती है। इसका भी कारण वही है कि अचानक इसका रिएक्शन आता है ना, टाइम जो है वो जितना टाइम लग रहा है उतने टाइम पे यहाँ पे कम है, लेकिन अगर कोई सैंड के ऊपर अगर आप जंप करो तो सैंड जो है वो नीचे अंदर धंस जाता है, तो उस केस में क्या होता है कि टाइम की जो वैल्यू होता है वो बढ़ जाता है। तो इसमें यहाँ पर इंपल्स की वैल्यू शार्ट स्पैन होना चाहिए, एकदम शार्ट स्पैन हुआ मतलब इंपल्स की वैल्यू ज़्यादा है, टाइम अगर कोई थोड़ा सा अगर कोई गेप बढ़ गया, टाइम बढ़ गया, तो उसका इम्पैक्ट जो है वो कम पड़ता है और चोट लगने की संभावना कम होती है। तो इस तरह से सेवरल, या मड़ी लैंड हो गया या रेत वाला हो गया, उसमें हमें चोट कम लगती है। तो इस तरह से सेवरल एग्जाम्पल्स जो है वो इंपल्स से रिलेटेड दिया जाता है, बट कंसेप्ट इज सिंपल। इसका तुमको यूनिट और डायमेंशन भी लिख लेना चाहिए। यूनिट क्या होगा इंपल्स का? यूनिट ऑफ इंपल्स इज यूनिट। फिर से तो यूनिट को डायमेंशन के फॉर्म में कन्वर्ट ये किया, मैंने यूनिट पूछा था। अच्छा, तो यूनिट ऑफ इंपल्स
न्यूटन सेकंड,
दैट आई इज इक्वल टू फोर्स मल्टीप्लाइड बाय डीटी, फोर्स मल्टीप्लाई बाय टी, तो दिस इज न्यूटन सेकंड, एंड डायमेंशन इज फोर्स इज MLT माइनस 2, दिस इज टी, तो दिस इज MLT माइनस 1, इज इट? So this is a new physical quantity, so you should write its unit and dimension, and obviously that unit in SI system, that is Newton second, force multiplied by time, and the dimension is this MLT minus 1. So this dimensionally, this is mass multiplied by, this is velocity, so its dimension is equal to momentum. Okay, this is mass and this is velocity. So mv, so it is the dimensional equal to momentum. So change in the momentum, also we are showing here. So I is equal to p2 minus p1. Now, Newton's third law of motion. So Newton's third law of motion. So first law is related to inertia, second law is related to force, and now third law is related to action and reaction. So according to third law of motion, every action has its reaction in opposite direction. Each reaction has its own. Each action has its own reaction in opposite direction. So this is simply third law of motion. Okay, so if we have one body, this is another body, this is another body, this is one body. If this body apply a force on this is body A, this is body B, so body A applies a force on B, then B will apply the same force but in the opposite direction to A. So if this force is along this direction, that is FAB. This is applied force by A on B, that is FAB, then B will apply the same force in the opposite direction, that is FBA. Force applied by B on A, force applied by A on B. So this it is written mathematically as FAB is equal to FBA. And the, since the direction is opposite, so we just take one minus sign here. So magnitude is same, but the direction is opposite. AB is equal to minus FB. So there is, again, there is no external force applied here. There is no external force applied here. We have two bodies. One body is A, another body is B. A is applying force on B, and B is applying the force in the A. So on A, so this FAB is equal to FBA in equilibrium system. And this minus sign is there to show the direction support. Another example one can have, if this is the table, one body is here of mass M, then the force applied by this body and this is equal to MC, the weight of that body assessed due to that acceleration due to gravity, and the reaction force, this is a table, the reaction force by this table is this is represented by R. So R is taken as equivalent to mz. So the reaction and action and reaction. This is the action. Action is mg and the reaction is R. So action is equivalent to reaction, and the direction is opposite. This is third law of motion. Okay. So these are the example, and one thing we should take care of it is the action and reaction both are in two separate bodies. A का एक्शन जो है अगर कोई बी में है तो बी का रिएक्शन जो है वो ए में है. कभी भी एक्शन और रिएक्शन सेम बॉडी पे नहीं होता है. एक्शन और रिएक्शन जो है वो अपोजिट डायरेक्शन पे होता है. इक्वल तो रहेगा, इक्वल रहेगा, डायरेक्शन अपोजिट रहेगा, साथ ही एक्शन और रिएक्शन जो है वो दो अलग अलग बॉडी पे होता है. ठीक है, ए का एक्शन जो है बी पे है तो बी का रिएक्शन जो है वो ए पे है. तो एक्शन और रिएक्शन जो है वो दो सेपरेट बॉडी पे होता है. इस चीज को ध्यान में रखना. सो दिस आर द सिंपल टर्म्स ऑफ दिस third law of motion. And one statement is given that second law of motion is main law of motion, because that first law of motion and third law of motion can be derived from second law of motion. So let us try to think that first law of motion and third law of motion on the basis of second law of motion. So the second law of motion, what is that? So first of motion from second of motion. So let us think about the first law of motion. In context of second law of motion. So we can derive first law of motion from the second law of motion. Second law of motion is told that the force F, it is equivalent to from second law of motion. But we have a definition of force that is equal to mass multiplied by acceleration. We have derived this F is equal to mass multiplied by acceleration. This is from the second law of motion. If external force F is equal to zero, then M multiplied by A is equal to zero. We are not taking mass is equal to zero. This implies acceleration is equal to zero. Acceleration zero means what? If A is equal to zero, what it means? It means object is either at rest or moving with constant velocity. If object is at rest, object rest means acceleration is zero. Object is moving with constant velocity means the acceleration is zero. So if this acceleration is zero, what it means? It means that object is at rest or that object is moving with constant velocity when this force is zero. So this is the statement given in terms of first law of motion. If there is no external force applied, then that object will be either at rest, if initially at rest, or moving with constant velocity. If it move, it is already moving with constant velocity. So this is the first law of motion. So the third law of motion in context of from this second law of motion. So if we have this one body, this is A, this is another body, and this is B. Action is from A to B along this. This is FAB, and the reaction is that FBA. So what we have to prove, this FBA is equal to FAB. So the momentum, the force F is actually equal to rate of change of momentum from the second law of motion. The force F, it is equal to rate of change of momentum. So this FAB can be written as equal to that dPAB by dt, and that FBA, the force applied by B to A, that's equal to rate of change of momentum for this thing. Mathematically, this is the dPB by this. So that FAB plus FBA can be written as equivalent to dPAB by dt plus dt, that is PBA. This is d by dt PAB. Since there is no external force here, there is no external force. Again, since there is no external force, so this PAB plus PBA can be written as equal to zero. So this FAB plus FBA is equal to zero, and this implies FAB is equal to FBA. इसी प्रकार में कोई फोर्स नहीं लग रहा एक्सटर्नली, सो द रिजल्ट एंड टोटल मोमेंटम विल बी जीरो. सो द टोटल मोमेंटम इज टेकन एज जीरो, सो दिस इज जीरो. सो वन कैन राइट दिस एफ आई इज इक्वल टू माइनस एफ बी. सो फ्रॉम सेकंड लॉ वी कैन डिराइव थर्ड, दैट्स व्हाई द सेकंड लॉ इज गिवन मोर एडवांटेजेस. इट्स द रियल लॉ ऑफ मोशन, द सेकंड लॉ ऑफ मोशन. Some daily life example of third law of motion. Because of that third law of motion, हम चल पाते हैं. अगर हम अर्थ पे एक्शन कर रहे हैं और अर्थ अगर कोई रिएक्शन ना दे, हाँ, तो या तो हम खड़े रह जाएंगे या पुड़ांग रिएक्शन दे, अपोजिट और इक्वली रिएक्शन ना दे करके कुछ और रिएक्शन दे तो गिर जाएंगे.
बाल
का कौन सा? हाँ, बॉल का जो बॉल अगर आप पिच कर रहे हो ग्राउंड पे तो वो अपोजिट डायरेक्शन पे बाउंस करता है. तो एंड अगर एक्शन और रिएक्शन जैसे हम कह रहे हैं, अगर बाय द वे हम ऐसे स्ट्रेट एकदम स्ट्रेट खड़े हैं इसी प्रकार का कोई, तो सिंपल खड़े हैं तब भी इधर हमारा वेट के बराबर एक्शन है और उसने रिएक्शन जो है वो आर है, सेम डायरेक्शन पे इसने स्टंट से किया. लेकिन जब हम चलते हैं चलते हैं तो ये फोर्स का जो डायरेक्शन होता है वो ऐसे होने के बजाय फोर्स का डायरेक्शन ऐसे होता है. हम इस डायरेक्शन पे फोर्स लगाते हैं जब हम चलने की कोशिश करते हैं. तो हम इस ढंग से तो बॉडी का जो पोस्चर है वो ऐसा होता है कि फोर्स जो है एक्शन फोर्स का जो डायरेक्शन होता है वो ये इस डायरेक्शन पे होता है. दिस इज फोर्स अप्लाइड बाई अस ऑन द ग्राउंड एंड द डायरेक्शन ऑफ रिएक्शन फोर्स दिस इज आर बाय द ग्राउंड. तो एक्शन एंड रिएक्शन ये इस डायरेक्शन पे हो रहा है. हम चल इसलिए पा रहे हैं क्योंकि हमारे पास इसके हॉरिजॉन्टल कंपोनेंट है, दैट h इज इक्वल टू f cos थीटा, इसलिए हम आगे बढ़ पाते हैं. और हमारे पर अर्थ का जो इंपैक्ट है वो वर्टिकल कंपोनेंट के फॉर्म में इस डायरेक्शन पे है, दैट इज वर्टिकल p इक्वल टू f दिस r, सॉरी r sin दिस इज थीटा. सो दिस इज r cos थीटा एंड दिस इज r sin थीटा. सो ये r sin थीटा तो हमारे बैलेंस के लिए लगा ही है हम पे, है ना? आर साइन थीटा हमारे बैलेंसिंग के लिए, हमारे वेट के लिए तो लगा ही है. हम इसलिए चल पा रहे हैं क्योंकि हमारे पास ये आर कॉस थीटा हॉरिजॉन्टल डायरेक्शन पे एक्शन पे है. ओके, लेकिन अगर चुपचाप ऐसे खड़े रहे तो एक्शन और रिएक्शन जो है वो लीनियर इस पे रहेगा, खड़े रहेंगे. लेकिन जब हम चलते हैं तो ये टर्म जो है वो इफेक्टिव होता है, आर दिस आर कॉस थीटा. ओके, सो देयर आर सेवरल एग्जांपल्स ऑफ द थर्ड लॉ ऑफ मोशन. सो दिस चैप्टर विल बी कंटिन्यूड एंड obviously we will have several other examples in regarding related to first law of motion, second law of motion, third law of motion. So in the next class we will discuss about the conservation of momentum, and there again we have to use the same relations. Okay, thank you.